what's going on, it's Mr. Katz, and today we're going to be building a forge. Let's get into it.
So for building the forge today, I'm going to need a couple things. So I'm just going to grab that stuff. Need some gloves.
Okay, so I got this half kind of barrel trough thing here. You may not have one, but I do. And I'm going to be using this as the base for the forge. So right now, I've just got to pull that thing out of there. And that's why we brought the chain. This thing's been stuck in there for a while. And I'm hoping it comes out easily. So I would use something that's like a lawnmower. But fuck, that thing's stuck. Whoa. Whew. Not really moving. It's in there. I doubt you could see that because I was probably standing in the way. But that was a lot of work. So. Fucks in. Hold it. Well. Okay, so here's what we got. There's holes in it. I don't know what to say about that. I don't know if that's going to help me or if it's going to be worse, but there's holes in it. Looks to be like half a propane tank or something along those lines. I'm not really sure what's inside of it. Aside from a bunch of garbage. What the fuck? Forge, they said. It would be fun, they said. Figure all that steel wire out of here. So we don't catch it with the lawnmower. Dirt. Wire. I think we're good. We gotta go get the truck. Bring that thing back. So it seems that this thing's a heavy piece of shit, and I have to load it by myself. Oh fuck. And I made the 17, but it's so heavy. That was a bad idea. I just launched air out of all those holes. I got a bunch of scrap steel though. I got some exhaust piping. We're making maybe an air tube. First, we gotta fix these legs. This thing's fucking heavy! Jesus! The struggles of building a forge only gets worse. You add more weight to a forge. I used to see you over by the hose there. My dad always says you should probably only touch the thing once. If you're gonna touch it, just put it away. Bring it where you gotta bring it. But I'm gonna unload this. Spray it off. Reload it. And then go up to the garage there. I could probably work out of here. Got a little storage shed behind us. Actually, a rather big storage shed. You could probably fit a couple cars in there. But I'll be back with the hose. So I got the hose, and I just see it's running, because I'm too lazy to walk back. Hopefully this doesn't end well. Hopefully this ends well, I should say. So now that we got the hose, I'm going to load
good big piles of shit. Hopefully, we can make it work. One dude pretty fucked here. He's all cattywampus on it. I'm all cattywampus there. That never stopped anybody. We're making a great fort. But that's fucking solid, I can say that. It just broke, I think. So it looks like that one leg is definitely fucked and may need to be welded back on. So this forge might not get finished today. But we'll do our best.
I don't know if you guys can see that or not. You can just kind of catch the little spittles there, but we sprung a leak.
No biggie.
Building the forge takes precise measurements. Not really, but it's fun to say. Building a forge doesn't take much. All it takes is a containment vessel, such as this, an air supply, which we're going to get to, and it's pretty much something insulated, I guess. If you build an in-ground forge, there, they can pretty much dissipate all your heat very quickly through the ground. So you don't want that. Sure ain't no beauty contest, but she might work. Hopefully that camera angle's good for you. So I haven't done much yet along the lines of straightening his legs, moving it actually. Right now we're gonna straighten the legs. I got my torch and I got my hammer. I don't know how well this is going to work. I also know it's very hot outside with a black t-shirt on. That's a weird fucking spider right there. That's a big spider. Weird little fucking big fat spider. Okay. First things first, the hand tip. Well, that's good. Good to know. We'll be welding this on now. Probably might as well both on while we're at it. A huge fail. Well, check out that show. I'll be wearing safety goggles and earplugs. I'll be right back. Okay, so I got my earplugs in, my safety glasses. I was just gonna try to move it. Turns out it's not gonna work. And that's it. It's not gonna work. So we're gonna heat it up with the torch. And hopefully we don't run out of gas here, mosquito. I'm not quite sure what to expect from this, if it'll even work. What I do know is I don't have my goggles on, but I don't know if I should actually. I don't have my gloves on, as you can see, and I don't know if that's going to affect me. Probably should put them on, but I'll burn myself. Blacksmithing 101. If it's hot, put a glove on. We are not going to get this hot enough. With this torch here. Let's see why it was junk now. So it turns out, I'm not gonna get this. Let's cool that down. Turns out we're not gonna get this straight. Not anytime soon, anyways. Oh, our. Yeah. I don't know if that's in the shot or not, but that's a 12-pound sledgehammer. It should work now. I hope. Not exactly what I planned. But if it wasn't gonna bend straight, I was gonna cut it off anyways. Time to make wooden legs.
So I may have not gotten what I wanted to happen. I probably shouldn't have cooled that down. I probably should have left it hot. But ultimately, we weren't gonna get the other leg on anyways, so I think it kind of worked out a little bit. So I got some wood here, as well as a 77 round Sherrill seat, but I have some wood. Not my wood, apparently, or not, it isn't my wood, actually. But I mean, a couple pieces of 2x4, actually. I got some 2x4. I'll go grab that. 2x4 should look better. We're just gonna stand for it, and yeah, so see you then. Okay, so we're down in the forge area. As you can see, there's the lazed remains of a couple pallets that I've been burning. Yes, I burned wood. Here's my current forge. Honestly, it's not that great. That's why I'm building this above ground forge, so I can forge more stuff, just to get the metal hotter, honestly, because that ground just soaks all that heat away and it's bad. Here we got, first thing I made, a coal rake. Not that great, but I'm down here because I need these. These here are 2x4s. Looks like we're going to need about 3. I'll probably grab 4 just to be safe. Catch you back up. We're building the forge. Hope you guys enjoyed this part of the forge build. Stay tuned for the next 2 parts that are out and coming. I've had this footage for over 2 weeks now, and I do have a significant amount of other footage. For example, we built some tools, we built some jewelry, and I'm going to be releasing all that over my channel. So hit that like button on this video before you go over to my channel and hit that subscribe button. Hope to see you guys in the next one.